Hi guys! So welcome back to another episode of TKKFM! So this episode, this week is actually episode 6. Actually this week we are talking about gaming. Wow! Very interesting topic.
So today we have two of our friends here, Gabriel and you. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Gabriel. I'm from class 42 and from Chen Orchestra. You may recognize me from SO or Project Phase.
And hi, I'm Luke. I'm from 4i4.
Thank you.
So today we're talking about gaming. So let's just start off with what our experience is in gaming. So do you have any
experience in gaming?
Okay, personally, contrary to popular belief, I actually don't game that much. As I prioritize other things in life.
Alright? Yeah, then what would you do in assembly?
But, as if I had to speak from a gamer's perspective, I think that gaming can help to relieve stress. And there are other benefits to gaming other than everyone seeming to...
What are the benefits?
Oh, do you watch
Next Friends?
What friends are you made?
Myself.
Wait, do you watch last week's episode?
Yes.
And then, do you hear what I said about how...
Yes, I remember that you said that you can sacrifice everything else, but you cannot sacrifice sleep.
Yes.
And that's how I then.
So how many hours of sleep should you have?
8, 7.
So how many hours did you sleep last night?
7.
I don't sleep in lessons.
You don't sleep in lessons? Yeah. Okay,
so Gabriel, what do you think about gaming?
I think that actually gaming does have its benefits, as you responded up. But the reason why I don't really game is because I think that, at least for me, in my case, harms outweigh the pros in the sense.
Why?
Because I feel like these days I'm pretty stressed for time. There's like a lot, you know, like for most Hwanghwangians as well, there's a lot of project work and CCA attacks and on top of like various other commitments. So I feel like gaming as a way of relaxation is a bit too time consuming and fast.
Actually a lot of the games now are like 40.
Yeah. Yeah, all those like shoot people.
Like, the Battle Royale.
Yeah,
Fortnite.
Have you ever played any games before?
Yeah, definitely. I've tried a few games before. Especially during like the longer holidays, like June and early December. My family actually likes playing some of these FPS games together. Like,
wait,
it's
a
family?
Yeah.
So it's like a family bonding activity. So I.
Yeah,
but other than that, during
the
school term, I don't
really game.
PUBG, that's it.
PUBG.
I
think
I played
it already.
Yeah,
I played
it before.
PCMI.
Yeah, I always have.
Actually, I completely agree with what Gabriel says, that it like takes up too much time. And considering I also quite a lot of commitments, I honestly can't spare that time.
Yeah.
So I don't really play like long games. If I have to play games, I usually like...
Also, it's like you get to relax like your senses and then like keep the brain activity down.
Sleeping, not gaming. No, but gaming is actually quite fun to do with your family. Like at home, I have a Switch, so I play Overcooked with my family. But it's so fun, like, this good family bonding.
So are there any games in particular that you like to play? Stumble guy.
Okay, I like to play like Brawl Stars. It's like, I'm
not Kevin.
Kevin from behind the camera is also playing Brawl Stars.
He was top 50 when he was in Sec 2 at his prime.
Yeah, that was all Brawl Stars.
I also play like Brawl Stars because, I mean, quite a lot of my friends play as well. So, I feel that if it's number one, it can't take enough time, it's worth a dollar already. And also, like, if it can, if I can spend time with my friends doing it, like, okay, so basically, for example, doing some like 7 minutes or whatever, right, like, before you just start, like, before you start playing, then I'll just, like, it's also a good bonding activity for, like, for SLC, we have, for you to call to play a few other some kind of board games like that, because it's also quite fun, it's also quite, because of considering that, I feel, yeah, it's a bit hard to bond with people.
No, maybe like sometimes it takes away from it. Like, let's say that you go on a group of friends, and then sometimes like half of you just start like moving on the bus. It's rather rubbing with very weird.
But if you do it together, you can.
But if everyone's inside, then it's a different thing. Like, but doing like a few people, then it's
different.
So, what do you think?
I think so too. Especially for people who don't play games like me. At times when I go out with my friends, sometimes everyone's like talking about it. They don't like me playing about it, but like they're talking about it. And then I can't really engage in a conversation unless I play the game before. So in a sense, I would be left out of the conversation. Yeah.
Double City. So, Liu, would you say gaming eats up a lot of your time?
As I said, I don't really think it does because I purposely make sure I unless it's like on the commute back to school or to school. Yeah, but I think something that we should probably like talk about as well is about gaming addiction, right? And how we can overcome it. So I feel that personally I have kind of been addicted to gaming, definitely second and maybe section of course become a subject or whatever, right? So basically what I did for section, because I felt like quite addicted to sort of like computer games. So for EY, I completely deleted my social media and all my games. So, I think that was for 2-3 months, and that really helped. And it also helped as a good plan. So, at the start of my sector, all those bad habits from the previous year, they didn't really carry on this year. Because, I don't know, I realized that I can live my life perfectly fine without the need or, without wanting to be.
Wow! Intervention.
Intervention. Counseling.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, I think when I was in primary school, you know the game Club Penguin.
Oh god.
Yeah, I used to be so addicted to Club Penguin. I would go home and every day I'll play and feed my people. It was so bad. But they were really cute, but I was addicted to the game. I would go home every day and I'll play.
Actually, what do you do?
Yeah, like, you don't really games, you can go around.
Do you not play it? Do you not play it?
I think
it's crazy.
Yeah. It is.
But is it like Animal Crossing?
No, Animal Crossing is like watching.
Okay, wait, then Gabriel, I just have a question for you. As a person that doesn't really game, right? Then how would, from your perspective of things, how could people with gaming addictions help slow down and keep their life back on track with the stuff that I actually
like? I think from a perspective of a non-gamer, to non-gamers, life can perfectly go on without gaming. But for people with gaming addictions, especially at the point of time when they're trying to curb it, it definitely won't seem so. So, like what you pointed out earlier, I think having the right mindset is the most important. And they have to start by taking small steps in trying to regulate their games. I don't think everyone has the courage or boldness to do what you did and just delete everything. But maybe trying to cap it at a certain duration per day would help.
I think something that's the most important is really the awareness that you are addicted and you need to stop. Because you need to see a sense of pattern in your daily life and you know that gaming has taken out a certain amount of your time. Because for example, sometimes I look at my screen time on my phone, I'd rather be able to do gaming and I'm just I actually kind of ashamed because I don't know, I spend that much of my day doing it.
What's everyone's average screen time?
I mean, last time I checked was six.
Okay, for last week. How much do you think?
6.5 hours.
Actually, on a good week, mine would be 4. Maybe a good margin week. But also, it depends. Because I feel sometimes when I use my laptop, it also counts as screen time. Then if you count in the laptop, it actually like really adds up to a lot more. But then usually it'll be like, usually, oh god, usually time will be like 6 or like 5, 6.
I don't use iPhone, so I've actually got no particular way to track my screen time. But I think what Clarence pointed out is quite true. I have a laptop at home, and you may sometimes choose to like play games or watch YouTube on your laptop instead. So that should also then be counted towards your screen time. And but it's not really counted if you only take games from iPhone. So yeah, you have to calculate the other devices as well.
Yeah, I think it's okay, but as long as it's moderation, like you don't like too much. It's not wrong to use your phone or watch your phone. Like, I'll say like, as with our days, I sleep 6 hours.
I think that's quite standard.
Yeah, it's quite standard.
Everyone's using their phones for like,
everything.
Communication, education.
Yeah, even if you want to like contact people now.
Yeah.
I think anything about 8 hours is a bit concerning.
But the point of view is that like, I open it, let's say 50% is like YouTube.
Yeah. There was this one week I was sick in school, and then my screen time was like 10 hours.
But I think it, when you're at home, your screen time is
yeah, like circuit breaker.
Yeah.
So, like, that's a dumb. Okay, so do you guys have anything you want to say? Like, your final words on TKKFM?
My advice.
Yeah. The last words on the
I would say that, actually, like what you said earlier, like, I think that there's some sort of stigma against like people who excessively do. But as a school, what we can do always is that we see our friends struggling, we shouldn't like shy away from them, but instead we should encourage them and try to help them cut their addiction. Because I think friends do play quite a big part in influencing their other friends as well. And if you can set a good example, I'm quite sure your friends will follow.
So you don't like it.
Okay, for me, I think like, as I said just now, if you are a gamer, then the first thing you need to check yourself is whether that's taking up too much of your time and whether it's really becoming an addiction. And another part that then after that you should take small steps as well, to slowly cut that addiction. And besides spend like a certain amount of time, gaming, a certain amount of time like doing proper work every single day, and have that like set a time limit for yourself to like
okay. Well, thank you for coming down today. I think we will end this episode here. Okay. Bye.
And remember to follow our Instagram at @HSC. And if you search TKFM on Spotify, our podcast will be there too.
If anyone wants to do this point, we love you so much.
Yeah.
Bye.